This idea of comparing labels, we're going to explore that through an example. L1 is uppercase, L1 is lowercase L1, comma, comp 1. And similarly, L2 is lowercase label L2 is lowercase L2, which is the level, sensitivity level of label 2, comma, comp 2. Okay, so the comparison is going to yield what we call, what label dominates the other label. Okay, so L1 can dominate L2, L1 can be dominated by L2, or maybe neither one dominates the other one. So these are the various possibilities. So L1, label L1 is going to dominate label L2 if level 1 is greater than level 2, and the categories or the topics that make up compartment 1 contain the topics or categories that are in compartment 2. So essentially, we're saying L1 is going to dominate if it's higher sensitive level, and the categories actually are a superset or contain the categories of compartment 2. If it's dominated, then it's the other way. Okay, so in that case, label L2 is the dominating one. So obviously, level L2 has to be greater than level L1, and the containment that we had before has to be in the other direction. Okay, so this is the subset relation that we have here. For the two labels to be equal, of course, each part has to be the same. So the levels have to be the same and the compartments have to be the same. So if L1 and L2 are not comparable, and what do we mean by that? That means it's one of the first three. They're not equal and neither one dominates the other one. Then we say that, they're not comparable. L1 doesn't dominate L2. L1 is not dominated by L2. And the reason for that is we're talking about a label having two parts. So levels are obviously totally ordered. So you cannot be, you're not comparable. It's not because, the levels that you have within your label L1 and L2. It's actually going to be because the compartments are sets. And these sets are going to be, neither one is going to be contained in the other one. So they each had some elements the other one doesn't have. And because of that, this containment property is not going to be satisfied. And because of that, neither of these are going to be holding. And when they don't, then we say that these labels are not comparable. So one thing, if you take these labels and arrange them, sort of what kind of structure you get, mathematics, actually there's a name for that structure. It's going to form a lattice. And when you have a lattice, you have the elements that are the least upper bound and the greatest lower bound and things like that. So you can always find labels, that would dominate any set of labels that you have. So that would be, finding an upper bound, and you can find the smallest such upper bound. So that's LUB and things like that. So when you compare these and sort of arrange and what's dominated by who, we get the structure because of the partial and the total order we have on the different parts. The structure you get is what is called a lattice.